And I may not use this whole clip, but I just want to make a scrapbook of album 10, if you can believe it. We made it all the way. I can just hear the fireworks now. But anyways, we're going to go ahead and play Greatest Hits, and I'm going to kick this old Greatest Hits off with this first song I'm recording. And it's all re-recordings of Dead Teddy Rider songs that already exist. This one, going to have a commercial before, no, refrain. Four Horsemen. Happy accidents. You heard their first song, The Greatest Hits. We're going to keep the camera rolling, and we made an executive decision a second ago to do a song from CD2 called Lake Vallecito song, which is the reason why is because my dad's on this track, and I think that is really reason enough we're going to pick it. So enjoy the Lake Vallecito song. That was Four Horsemen. Here's track 2 of the greatest hits, CD 10, the Lake Vallecito song from Dead Tell You Riders Leviathan. Oh, this one has an ad, so give me a second. The third track to the greatest hits after doing those both lovely songs. This is off Vagabond Prince. It's called Heaven's Gravel.
last night, so smoking 10. He was saying we could shroom up till we freaking win, till we freaking win. I noticed the steel doors wouldn't let anybody in, like there was some kind of Da Vinci or some Crowley hide at this minute's drawing to the note. It was very dull for us to follow the bell. My exes let me follow the bell. And Sunday there was kind of like hell. When we passed the gravel test, we knew just what it meant. The Church of the Heavenly Angels, they hadn't been there yet, but the door popped open. Like it. Was inviting us to our last night of Sunday. Anyway, they were no fun. We were all alone. When I walked in, there was a grid of lads work shirt in that old bit busted shack. The preacher on the right, he laughed over me when I sat down. Laughed so hard that I stood up and they offered plenty of bread. I was dropping offering everywhere that I freaking could. And then I sat down and everyone stood up like they always should. The Lord's Prayer didn't mix there. Heard the name of Beelzebub. Gave me a bad feeling. Got my axe on my shoulder, rubbed on my shoulder. Did you see? In the middle there was a fat preacher. Looked like a preacher. He kind of looked like he was some kind of dark creature. He had a giant robe on and one. I heard some bats. Suddenly he caught me in the bottom of my rats. Bottoms up. In the left, the preacher in the dark was not afraid. Suddenly, you needed all the times we made the grade, made the grade, made the grade. My wife was there to see us if we cannot get us in. On the left was the lady. She was looking for the chin, looking for the chin. There were people standing in line, so I took turns to go. Suddenly a spirit rushed in back to the middle. I don't know what happened next, I don't know what was in the back room in Heaven's Gravel, Church of Heavenly Angels again. When I saw her there, we took her to the chair, and then we were prepared to enter into the air, enter into the air. I was feeling kind of nauseous from all that weed we smoked, but I could tell the others wanted to die there when they're broke, die there when they're broke. But we weren't broke.
And cut.
So,
Pointerite Trash tried to play Clifton Village South. This is from the Frying Dutchman concert, disc 5. And this is a track towards this, the third act. Well, here we go. We're already on track 6, album 6, Culture Relief. And, you know, we're going to label some of these tracks and descriptions along the way. And fortunately, this makes my job easy because we've recorded, as Dead Tell Your Riders, almost 85 tracks together. And I think this is one of the finest. This is Pick Fair from Culture Relief, track 6 of the greatest hits. Stirred up and shaken amidst. Well, here we are back at Dead Tail Your Rider Central, and I gotta say, this Greatest Hits album is going pretty well. I don't really have to do much except play the Greatest Hits, and I wanted to play Pain and Misery off of album 7, Vietnam, because although there's some really select talents off that work, I thought it was real interesting that the final track was my first in collaboration with Mark Frederick, which really opened up the new system for my band and how we make music now. He writes it and I play it. And this is really the one that got us started on that. And it's called Pain and Misery. And I think you'll like it. And we're going to have a couple more that he wrote and I played to finish out this album. I'm Reboot on you. Okay, we're doing Confederate Atheist, a big album for the Dead Tay Riders, and this is the greatest hits, track 8 from their 8th album. We've been tracking along as the Dead Tay Riders have gone album to album. I'm real excited to present, as what I'll explain to you in this video, as Dear Agony, a song that was on Confederate Atheist that went within 24 hours to YouTube Music. Dead Tay Riders Central. I'm here with Mark Frederick, and you know, he's going to be in an interview soon, and we're putting together the greatest hits. And you know, this is interesting because this is album 9, and I got to be totally dead honest. As much as I want to make jokes and be silly and say, well, the Salem Witch Trials were just an excuse for metal music later, that could be. But the point is Curse of Salem is actually an album that started out as a good idea and ended as a great idea, and actually is my favorite of all the albums. It was hard to pick the greatest song off this because the whole album is such a player. Everything's legit, the whole thing is legit. I mean, it's not even just the we're not legit, so we're trying to be legit type. It's the legit. And I have for you track Mark Frederick wrote his great mind, and I was able to pound out one night a few weeks ago and finish this album, Curse of Salem, that is my favorite Dead Telly Rider album. And I bring it to you on the greatest hits. It's track Curse of Salem. The track is Curse of Salem. Another streamer, and I'm just amazed that we got through all that without crying too much, but I was crying a lot of it, just deep down, that the Dead Telly Riders are still going to release some more hits like that. But let's take a minute here and flash back all the way to the very first Dead Telly Rider song that was ever released, before there was ever Happy Accidents or any other song, and it wasn't even really a band, it was kind of just a weird idea. This song's been a hit of mine for a while and inspired the last 10 albums that were one day said would be made because of this, and well, here they are. right here, where it is for you. Well, you've heard it. You've heard it. The 10 albums of the Dead Telluriders. And guess what? There's at least 10 more to come. So stay tuned. And if you haven't checked out the Mark Frederick interviews that are coming on soon, check those out too. All right, peace out. Have a great Stitch Day.
Hello, my friends. Welcome to the Dead Telluriders interview. I'm band leader Aaron Sheely. I'm here with my new co-band leader. He is Mark Frederick. And I'm here to talk with him about an interview concerning his, basically, behind the music, how he got in with the Dead Teddy Riders, everything. So it's good to see you, Mark, and thanks for coming to the interview.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah. He debuted with Pain and Suffering on the album Vietnam, and then wrote the larger percentages of Confederate Atheist and Curse of Salem, two recent releases by the Dead Teddy Riders. So I've just got to ask you, Mark, and what was it that first gave you the idea to actually write music?
Well, I had it as a venting process, like, you know, to try to put out my emotions on paper. And it was later on that I had bumped into Aaron, and he said, hey, I could use these songs. And that's how we started.
Perfect. What a great answer. All right, so I must ask, because in all these interviews, this question is the most important. What has always been your favorite, most influential band, and could you give us a reason why?
Well, I would have to say Alice in Chains. I'm a big, big fan of Alice in Chains. They influenced me greatly over my music. I grew up with them. I was raised with them. They were a big part of my life, and I really enjoy them.
That's awesome, dude. Thank you. Thank you for going into that. All right. So my next question changes gears a little bit, but it goes into one thing. In writing music, in your music specifically, what are the things you like best about your themes or concepts or just your writing in general?
Well, I like that I can relate to a group of people and how they can say, hey, I've been there emotionally. I know how he feels. And to relate to it, and it's just, you know, it's great. I really like that.
That is really cool. Yeah. I saw that too when I was playing one of your songs, that you really captured a way that I had felt, and I had felt like something that you must have felt the same emotion, very, very depthful. And then the last question I have for you before I let you go, back to your regular amount of 50 songs a day. No, I'm kidding. But before I let you go back to your writing and other things that we will be doing throughout the day to wrap up album 9, I have to ask, where do you see the future of your writing in music headed?
Well, I feel like music is ever evolving. I feel like we're going to be so much more better of the band in the future. We're going to rock it. It's going to be awesome.
Well, you heard him here, folks. Mark Frederick says it's going to be awesome. And if there's one thing we know, he writes awesome lyrics. So if he says it's going to be awesome, well, my guess, it is. And cut.
For the band called Forever's Not As Long As It Seems, and really with the crossroads the band's at and our lives are and our relationships, I think these lyrics and this music kind of says it all about where we are as a band and as just people in general. Forever's not as long as it seems. My heart is unraveling at the seams. Missed you so long, what have I done? I've tried my best to put my love to the test. You said forever, but I guess you meant something like never. as old as the saints. It is your words that are ripping up my dreams. All hope is gone, I'll go mad from the loneliness. Not too long, once was blue, has turned black. With your words, my heart, they attack. I'm at the edge of the world, hanging on. I cry, and I want you back.
Thank you for watching this educational program and entertaining. Hopefully you've been entertained. I'd just like to ask you to tune in again when the Dead Tell Your Writers return in a little less than a month with a creation they're working on called Enter the Dragon. Goodbye.